Drew and T are leaving the team behind again to head up to Scotland to visit one of its oldest castles, just 20 miles away from Glasgow, near the small town of Kilmarnock.
This call to a castle like this is a dream call for any dealer. It really is. You don't get into Scottish castles.
Have the family been there long? I've noticed that sometimes if...
I think they've been there generations.
All right. So they won't have sold everything?
Don't know. Some families sell, some don't. Remember, these guys up in Scotland here had more money than God. They were seriously wealthy.
Buildings with a history stretching back centuries have been a rich hunting ground for Drew in the past. Set in 600 acres, the magnificent Crawfordland, dating back to the 1300s and extended over the centuries, is one of Scotland's oldest castles. It has links to the country's bloody wars of independence from England. It's a rare example of a fortified home that's still inhabited by the same family. Simon Hewison Crawford has lived here with his wife Aditi for 5 years. Together, they run a country retreat for paying guests.
Crawfordland Castle has been in our family since 1245, and I'm the 28th generation of Crawfords living at Crawfordland.
Simon and I have been here since November 2011. We moved from a tiny little cottage, and it was actually a really weird experience moving into a house that I hadn't really seen, and then trying to kind of make it your own. But it's a fully A-listed building, so there's not a lot we can actually do apart from change the colour of the paint.
They're hoping Drew will buy some of the historic antiques that have piled up in the castle over the centuries.
We have quite a lot of attic spaces in the castle. Drew might find quite interesting, so we thought we'd show him round and see what he thinks of what we've got here.
I'd quite like to buy that mirror. It's a very, very nice one. It would be over £1,000.
Yeah.
Might be touching £2,000.
Maybe.
If this Florentine-style mirror was handmade in the 18th century rather than mass-produced in the 19th, it would be a lot more valuable. So Simon has been checking his insurance inventory for more information.
So, does it say, number one, does it say 18th or 19th century, or even earlier?
18th.
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 And the figure is?
2.5.
Hmm. But it's maybe for sale. One day, maybe. I'd get very close to the 2,500 for it.
Right.
The problem with this type of house, and it comes up every single time, is all the pieces have been here a very, very long time, and because of various issues, they've always had to have them valued year on year. So they know the value of everything, they don't really want to sell it. Why would they? You know, you don't blame them, do you?
Unable to buy what he's desired so far, Drew is hoping his luck might change in one of the castle's storage rooms.
A hidden room.
This is, it's known as the butler's pantry. So we have old storage and new storage.
OK. Oh! Bunting.
Bunting, yeah. Some of it's in pretty poor state, though.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I love this.
Can they give us an end?
Oh. Wow. These are great.
Some of them are right.
Expect a pair of bloomers to come out.
Yeah. Oh, it's a shame the ends ones have got a bit ravaged, haven't they? Oh, tea. Hey, one for later.
We're not playing doctors and nurses in the van again.
Condition goes against that. That's really nice. Don't bin it. That's really nice. Damn it. Conditions just too
ravaged. Do you know, would it be worthwhile, even just for us, to put it into a long frame?
It would look brilliant framed.
But digging deeper into the boxes, there's something else that catches Drew's eye.
They're lovely, aren't they? Embroidered. Is that a family crest or something on there?
No, don't know what it is.
And it's got like a little baronial sort of double-headed eagle thing on the other side.
Yeah, that doesn't ring any bells with me at all.
They're just nice quality, you know, they're just well made. I found a pair of tassels, pulls, you know, on a piece of beautiful cord. They just hark back to an age when things were just done really, really well for the sake of just doing them that way. They completely had it. They're utterly useless. What I like about them is the wear.
These tassels, possibly over 100 years old, may have been used as curtain tiebacks in one of the grand rooms of the castle and could be worth around £150.
I'll certainly sell you that.
I'll give you £50 for them.
See me?
There you go.
The RT, that is not going to take you long to load, is it?
You could even put that in the van.
Those tassels that I bought would sell very, very quickly and very easily. They are of interest to two markets. One, interior decorators, or your country house dealers who would just have it as a little thing hanging on a wall.
With only one tiny profit opportunity found inside the castle, Drew asks to explore the outbuildings to see if there's anything else he can buy to make the trip worthwhile.
We're saying we had the bench you saw in the outer hall.
Yeah.
We used to have one either side of each other of the hall.
Right.
But the other one was over here, which is not in as good a condition.
God, yeah, it's in a terrible state, isn't it? Do you know where they came from?
No. Again, I could probably get a better idea for you because it was included in the valuation that was done 2011.
What did they value it at? I mean, it's in terrible, terrible condition. It's full of woodworm.
I think it was valued then at 700, but I know it's worth less than that now.
Simon believes this pitch pine bench pairs up with another in the castle hallway, which bears the family coat of arms, suggesting it could be more than 200 years old. In good condition, it could fetch around £2,500.
I'd like to see it go to a good home, to be honest.
Well, we can restore it and pass it on. £400?
Yeah.
Excellent. Well, there you go, that's £400. I've just kept my French polisher in business for another week. The good points about the bench are, one, it's the right price. It's a good restoration project. It's different as hell. I mean, you're not going to see many of these lying around. And it will appeal to the American market hugely.